What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back again with another video. Just finished watching Hell in a Cell. You can tell by my demeanor. I'm not as pleased as I thought I would be. To be honest with you guys, I only watched the Hell in a Cell matches. Everything else, I could have cared less. I don't even know the other matches. I just didn't care. So if there are, I'm just so discombobulated. If there are any other matches on the card that you guys think I should check out, let me know. I may go back and check them out at a later date. Probably not. Point is, man, the only thing I really truly cared about was the three Hell in a Cell matches that were advertised. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you, out of the three, there's only one Hell in a Cell match from this show, from this pay-per-view, that I thoroughly enjoyed, and it's really the main thing that has saved this show for me in just entertainment wise and that is none other than the women's championship match between Sasha and Bayley. I feel like it's the only match that actually truly deserved a Hell in a Cell. The match between Jay and Roman, I guess it makes sense because they're family. And then the match between Drew and Randy Orton, no. Now, I want to say this before I get into my thoughts and opinions on just the Hell in a Cell itself. I don't think it should have started with Roman and Jay. I think it should have started with Randy Orton and Drew McIntyre. The only reason why I say that, because I'm going to be honest with you, I didn't care for that match. I didn't care for the finish. I didn't care for them even having another match. And I might as well start with this match since we're talking about it, and reason why I think this should have went on first. Because if this would have went on first, I think I would have a better, I think I would feel a little bit better if how the show ended. Because the show ended with Randy Orton winning the championship, and in my opinion, I don't think he should have won it. And the reason why I say this is because how many times has Drew fought Randy this year alone and beat him within the stipulations of whatever match? Like, how many times? It's like three times. Why does he get another chance at the title? What happened to other stars getting their opportunity? And you want to know why he's the only one that gets a shot at his title? Because they haven't built up any other heels that are even worth Drew McIntyre's time. So Randy Orton was really the only option. And at this point, it made sense, because you're not going to have the dude lose another big pay-per-view match, because then it's like, we can't take Randy Orton serious. But I didn't take him serious as much as I did both prior to him feuding with Drew, because that was some of his best work. He was the top heel, in my opinion. Now it's Roman by a mile, but he was the top heel, and you took him as a threat. He was punting people into next week. Then Drew beat him. Then Drew beat him again. Then Drew beat him again. And it's like, every time Randy Orton lost, it's like, bro, I can't take you seriously. You lost. This match didn't need to be in a Hell in a Cell. They hit the same traditional tired old spots in Hell in a Cell. Of course, Randy climbs to the top. It doesn't make sense for Drew to want to climb up there. It doesn't make sense. He has to win. He has to beat you in the ring. But that's neither here nor there. He climbs up there. And just, there's a magical pipe for Randy Orton to use. Who just left a random pipe at the top of the cell? I may never know. But Randy uses the pipe. And then they gradually climb down the other side of the cell. And you know somebody's going to fall through there. You know, we've seen this spot before. And Drew ends up falling from the side of the cell. It's a nice spot, but it's a tired spot. Now, I do like the fact that they've made Drew look very, very strong. And you damn near have to use some type of weapon or something to take Drew down. And even then, it's not a guarantee. They have built him up as this very strong babyface. Obviously so, because he destroyed Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania. So you kind of got to keep that going. But even then, It didn't matter. I knew once Drew hit the Claymore, once they got back in the ring, he wasn't winning it. Took too long to get him back in the ring. He was setting him up for another Claymore. I knew he was going to miss, get hit with the RKO. Boom. 1, 2, 3. And that was it. And once again, it's just one of those things where it's like, you know they're going to have another match. Because who else have they built as a babyface that is even close to challenging Randy Orton? Nobody. Do I want to see another match from these two? No. But that's my take on it. That's why I said this match should have been first, because this was the last thing that you seen on as the pay-per-view ends. And I'm gonna be honest with you, it just I didn't care for it. I was like, all right, man, yeah, this sucked. It made me, it just drove the entertainment value out of me, because I was like, bro, this sucks. I didn't care for this match. So hey, it is what it is. I think this should have been on first. At least, you know what I'm saying, it would have hyped me up for the other Hell in a Cell, because I'm pretty sure I'm like, all right, well, I'm sure those will be better than this for sure. So let's get to my favorite Hell in a Cell of the night. Obviously, Sasha versus Bayley. Fantastic promo package. This match made sense to be in a Hell in a Cell. There is like a personal feud between two wrestlers that have grown up together in the ranks in WWE. It was fantastic, bro. And you know what's great about this? What makes this so good is the simple fact they didn't have to use no, oh, let's have the women climb on outside the Hell in a Cell. No, guess what they did? They used what was ever under the ring, in the ring. They used their creativity, and it was fantastic, bro. Brutal. I loved it. I loved the storytelling. This was just great. I enjoyed this match so much. It was just one of those things where I was like, yo, honestly, I'm not even gonna lie to you, man. This match, fantastic. I think honestly, this maybe this match in the Roman Reigns versus Jay should have been the only Hell in a Cell matches for this pay-per-view. Fantastic. One of my favorite spots is towards the end of the match. Sasha hits Bayley with her own finishing move, Bayley to belly onto the steel ladder. Brutal spot. Bayley looks like she was in pain. And then to top it off, Sasha had Bayley in her submission hold, but she had the chair, and it was so poetic. She had her chair between the where you sit at, had her in the submission hold pulling back, but also was stepping on the chair at the same time, so it was closing on her neck repeatedly. Oh, that was so great. So it was such a beautiful spot, and it was great to see Bayley tap, man. It was fantastic. Sasha definitely deserves the championship, and I am actually looking forward to seeing where their feud goes. I like the fact that the babyface was aggressive with it. She held the hold even after she clearly won the match. I love that. And I like the fact that when she was holding up the championship, she stood on Bayley's back. Thought that was great. This is how you build up a feud. Looking forward to seeing where they go, and hopefully they can definitely bring some more life into the women's division overall, which I know they will. Fantastic match. They stole the show for me, in my personal opinion. Now, the match that literally disappointed me the most, and the reason why I was disappointed is because of the potential. Obviously, Roman versus Jay. I'm not gonna lie to you, this should have had blood, some type of blood. This should have had blood. You've built this up as Jay not giving in, being defiant, and showing that he deserves to be where he is. And you've built up Roman as this, I don't care if you're my family, I'm going to end you type character. And it's one of those things where it's like, okay, you've done this, you built this up, right? Cool, fantastic. Roman's over here talking about there's going to be consequences. I want to see these consequences. I want to see the suffering. I want to see the pain. And they showed some of it, but I feel like there should have been some blood involved. Of course, we knew Jay wasn't going to win, but I do like the fact that they made Jay very strong in this match, because he didn't quit, and I like that. I think what would have been so dope, because they were talking trash, they were cussing when Jay had the leather strap. He was like, yo, I'm gonna whoop the dog s out of you. oh, I was like, yo, I like this trash talking. Roman was talking trash too. Like, this is how you would see them fight as a family, you know what I'm saying? And I think what would have been dope if he pulled a Brock Lesnar or a Stone Cold type move where he's beating the hell out of him. He asking him, say, I quit. And Jay doesn't say, I quit. All he says, gives Roman Reigns the middle finger. I think that would have been badass, been defiant to the end. I wish they would have did something like that. Give Jay a little bit of edge. But when the match started to like fall down for me drastically, because I was enjoying it up to the point where the ref was about to call the match, I was like, not this again. This is the second year in a row where someone, the referee, thinks it's okay to call a Hell in a Cell off. What times are we living in where you even think about calling off a Hell in a Cell? That makes no sense to me. So Roman's like, nah, I'm not having this, you know what I'm saying? Start attacking referees. Then he's about to, one spot I did like is when he had Jay against the turnbuckle, had the stairs right next to him. He hit the little slide that he does, the little jump slide onto the apron, hits the stairs, which hits Jay in the corner. I thought that was pretty brutal. But at this point, Jay's lifeless, and that's when other officials come in to try to stop the match, but no one rang the bell. So I'm like, bro, this doesn't make sense. It started getting convoluted real quick, and then this is where it gets really nonsensical. Roman Reigns is about to bash his own cousin's skull in with the stairs, and that's when Jimmy comes out. Be like, no bro, don't do this. And at that point you can kind of tell where things was going, and I just groaned, because I'm like, yo, this match is still technically going on and there's all these officials in here. And all of a sudden Roman starts crying, starts getting emotional, like, what are you doing? And he starts breaking down. I'm like, what is this? No, I don't want to see my tribal chief crying. I get it's all part of an act, but Jesus, no. And then all of a sudden he puts Jimmy in the submission hold, the guillotine hold or whatever, and then miraculously Jay wakes up. He's trying to fight him off, and then he says, finally, I quit, just to save his brother. And I thought that was so lame. Like, bro, you're telling me your ass was out of commission for this long, but once your brother get puts in a submission hold, and now it's, oh no, what are you doing? I quit. Like, no, bro, start beating his ass. I would have got a steel chair. I don't care how much stamina I had. Would have got a steel chair and started beating the I would have went in. Family or not, I would have went in. But at that point, I didn't care. That's when it kind of disappointed me. I do like what Roman was doing. I love his heel persona in this. I love it. It was fantastic. I just think the execution towards the end of the match was so overbooked and convoluted, just to find a way to get Jay to say, I quit. I thought that was pretty lackluster, and that's the only thing that I have, like, my only gripe about this match is the overbooking. But besides that, I enjoyed it for the most part. It's just towards the end, once you start talking about ending the Hell in a Cell, I get flashbacks to The Fiend and Seth Rollins, and nobody wants to think about that. So that's my thoughts on overall Hell in a Cell. Like I said, I've only watched the Hell in a Cell matches. Everything else did not care about. If I had to say, did I enjoy it? A little bit. Like I said, I enjoyed it for the most part. I think I was just expecting more from definitely the Roman and Jey Uso match. That's the only thing that's probably bogging it down for me a little bit, but it's enjoyable for the most part. I think if you were to check out the pay-per-view, check it out just for the women's match alone. That's it. If there's anything you check out on this pay-per-view, check it out for the women's match alone, because that match was fantastic. But comment down below, let me know, what was your favorite Hell in a Cell of the night? What was your favorite Hell in a Cell match of the night? Let me know the reasons why. And if you guys are looking forward to where they're taking these storylines, man. But I appreciate all the love and support. Road to 30K. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. See y'all on the next one. Peace.